before we get started, I have a question for you. And probably you have asked this question yourself at certain points in time. What's next? We all have this transition period in our life. After school, when we change jobs, or when we retire, when we ask ourselves these questions. And that used to be, or answering this question used to be a little bit more simpler. In the past, life was more or less linear. We thought about it as being born, going to kindergarten, going to school, going eventually to university, going to a job, climbing a career ladder, then retiring, and being happy ever after. But that's not the case anymore. As you know, now our ways and our world has become much more complex. And in good and bad ways, like there is more competition, global competition. There is competition for our jobs, but robots and AI. But there's also more opportunity. There's more opportunity when it comes to dating. There's more opportunity when it comes to work in a different place. There's more opportunity to travel the world. All these things don't make life any simpler. In fact, it raises the question, how do we change? Because in all these instances, you have the opportunity to change. But how do we go about it? And I don't know how you feel about these moments, but I feel about these moments a little bit scared and sometimes a little bit intimidated. Because I don't know, I don't always know what's the best option and what's the best way forward. And what's interesting about these moments is if we doubt them on an individual base, and if we think change is hard on an individual base, how can we think about these things as teams, as organizations, and as society? I think there are multiple parts to this puzzle. And for me, the first part is design. To quote Herbert Simon, everyone designs who devises courses of action aimed at changing existing situations into preferred ones. And that's a nice definition, but the problem is, how do you go about it? How do you change your life as it is right now into something or devise courses of action that lead to something that you think you want to be? The way to engage actually cleared up a little bit in early 2000 when the former dean Roger Martin of the Rotman Business School, as well as people from Stanford Business School and the design consultancy, IEL, popularized the idea of design thinking. For me, design thinking is an approach to learn to engage in design. It's not necessarily the same as the all design professions that we have out there. In the background, you see many models on how this has been described. So there are many ideas of what the process looks like. However, like when we look at these models, we know that they have three things in common. The first one is to understand. Understand not only what you want to go for, but also understand yourself, understand others, and understand the problem. The next thing is to ideate, to come up with ideas, with useful, optimal ideas about the future or what could be. And last but not least, we don't have any data about the future. So when you want to learn about the future, the best way to do that is to test a couple of things, to try things out in a way that informs and improves our understanding so we can come up with better ideas, better ideas about our future, no matter whether individual or on a larger scale. But design isn't everything, and this thing here is a concept store and has been put on the streets by Nike, and I use this example, I could have chosen any example, because I think it illustrates an important point. Design in itself is great, it helps us conceptualize, to come up with these ideas, but design in and of itself is not enough. I think you need other abilities and knowledge in order to actualize, to bring things into the world. And this ability and knowledge to conceptualize and actualize is what I would call innovation literacy. Now, what has this to do with designing life? I think the design life, it brings these two worlds closer together because we are the ones that conceptualize and that actualize. We are the ones driving our lives, driving our change, and we can think about that, we conceptualize and actualize that at any moment in time if we desire and want to do so. So, how can we go about this? Well, I want to show you three examples from work that my students have done, and that was done by people that I engaged with in my class. And, of course, the names have been changed, the identity has been changed, but I hope they give you a little glimpse of what this could look like. Let's start with understand. So this is about gathering data to reflect and develop a deeper understanding of yourself, what motivates you, and what's meaningful to you. And design is an integrative discipline, where integrative
he has approached. So he could draw on ethnography as well as political psychology to understand what is meaningful to people, what is meaningful to us, and how it motivates us. The example here, the first that I want to present to you, is Ingo. Ingo was one of my master students. When he started to understand that actually the thing that he wanted, by reflecting about his life and how he developed, what the thing that he thought he wanted was not actually what he really wanted. He thought he wanted to become a consultant at one of the top consultancies, as many MBA students want. But engaging in understanding himself and trying to figure out who he was and reflecting upon himself, he realized that was not what he wanted. But then, what? What's the next step? Here I want to introduce Mutinda. Mutinda is from Zambia. And although she attended business school, her future was like giving birth to 3 kids and raising them. That's what was her idea about her future. And she didn't sound like she had much choice. But engaging with class and with others, she realized there are actually options. There are ideas that she had in her head that she had almost forgotten about. And it showed her what she could do, not only like not as yet, but in parallel to the thing that she wanted, which was to raise 3 kids. And she started to think about how could she engage in having her own business. But ideas are dynamic, and they don't help us much in thinking forward. So we have to actually engage with them in order to learn and to see if this is actually what we want to buy. And this brings me to the next step, which is actually to test. Testing is about actualizing idea in order to learn from it. And here, we, in some exercise from behavior science, we think about what makes us tick. Why are we motivated to do certain things? And what can we do in order to engage in these activities that we want? Martha, for example, she wanted, as many as some of us do, she wanted to work out more. She wanted to become more fit. But we all have very full lives. So how is that possible? How should she get around herself to do that? So she had a couple of ideas. One was to work out for 1 week, like every morning, for 5 days straight. So on the first day, it didn't feel really good. Second day, reflecting on it, she realized that this is going to be a hard week. But then she met a friend at the gym. And all of a sudden, she realized she was a little bit more motivated to go on the third day. She also started to talk to others about this. And this is when it made quick for her. She realized in order to do anything, although she didn't want to stick to this routine, it was important for her to socialize, to have others to go with her. And learning that about herself informed her next step. So, this is how change for 3 of these students. And while this might not be the only approach, I think that when it comes to U2.0, it's important to cultivate what I would call innovation literacy, which is basically the ability and the knowledge around conceptualizing and actualizing, not only when it comes to yourself, but also when it comes to industries, societies, and other things. With that, I would like to leave you with an invitation. If you think that this is a way that you would like to try, or that you want to discuss, please reach out and have a chat. I'm always happy to discuss the topic, as I really love engaging in it. Thank you.